Well, moving on, the enthusiasts outdoors wearing sun protective glasses and the superstitious behind thick curtains ensuring the eclipse didn't touch them in any way. That's how India spent Friday.
Well, it was the longest solar eclipse of the century and it became visible around midday. South India got the best deal, and in case you missed it, here it is again.
Darkness at noon, a celestial spectacle, the longest annular eclipse of the century. In Rameshwaram, people were spellbound for about 10 minutes at midday, when the sun almost vanished from the sky.
The sun is just looking like a moon.
Children, pilgrims, scientists were all as excited. Thousands took a holy dip in the Ganga at the Kumbh Mela in Haridwar. Scientists at ISRO launched a barrage of small rockets to study the chemistry of the atmosphere, which incidentally took place over two of India's spaceports. So, what happens during an eclipse? In a rare confluence, celestial bodies, the sun, moon, and the earth align. And when the moon moves in between the sun and the earth, a dark shadow seems to move over the earth, plunging parts of the earth into semi-darkness for a brief period. When the moon is directly over the sun, some sunlight can still be seen from behind. And this looks like a perfect golden ring, or technically forms an annular solar eclipse.
The eclipse is brilliant. I mean, people who are not looking at it right now are missing a spectacle.
Hundreds of astronomers and tourists had gathered at the hotspots to view the spectacle. A special cruise boat chased the eclipse from India to the Maldives. With Radhika Iyer in Rameshwaram, Shanu Aluwalia in Malé, and Vasanti Hariprakash in New Delhi, Pallav Bagla for NDTV.
Tubar.com.